Good morning, Lancers. Welcome back to Lancers News. Again, we're back, Jaden and Sarah. So, on Wednesday, two of our terrific star athletes signed their national letter of intent. Let's take a look at how that went.
With Elijah Ponder and Ethan Rodriguez recently signing to play football at San Luis Obispo, we went to the signing to see how they felt about it.
Overall, I want to thank everyone who helped me through this process, and I'm extremely excited to be a part of the Cal Poly San Luis Obispo football team. Go Mustangs!
How do you feel about signing to San Luis Obispo?
I feel great. I'm happy with my decision, and I'm ready to go.
What made you decide to sign there?
It was free.
Thank you.
Lastly, I want to thank my parents and my sister. Mom, I don't know how you did it for 4 years, but you did.
What made you decide to sign with San Luis Obispo?
It's just the area. It was nice out there, and the education. It's a top education in the country, and then athletics too. It just felt give me a home feeling, and so it's a good day.
I also asked the coaches how they felt about the signing.
I'm happy for Elijah and Ethan. I think it's a good fit for them. I think that they're both capable of playing football at a higher level, but I think given what their goals are, be civil engineers, I think Cal Poly is an amazing school. And
I'm super excited for these two guys. I mean, they put a lot of work in. It was just a matter of where they wanted to go.
I'm Mr. Guru reporting for the Lance.
Lancers, today is the last day to submit a design for the sweatshirt design competition. The winning design will be sold at the student store. Check your email for more details.
And now for some club announcements. The Maker Club will have a planned meeting on Monday after school in Lab 205. All members, be sure to attend.
The Japanese Club will meet today after school in Room 104, but they will be preparing for Japanese visitors coming next week. Don't miss out.
Attention, all Jawas, bounty hunters. Star Wars Club will be watching The Mandalorian today at lunch in Room 501.
Next week during the Valentine picnic, the Maker Club will be doing face painting and selling handmade Baby Yoda keychains. To place an order for your Baby Yoda before they sell out, sign up in Lab 109.
The Esports Club season is soon underway. Let's take a look at the upcoming LOL tournaments.
Following a successful Overwatch season and the spring season now on the horizon, the Esports team is looking forward to take on the game League of Legends. Mr. Torres gave us insight into the game's background and tournament's format.
Yes, we are looking to start our new season. We're playing League of Legends, which is a MOBA. So the league we're in, we play, there's four different time zones in the United States that they broke it up to brackets. So we'll play in our bracket. And then if we make it to the playoffs, we'll be playing the other brackets throughout the United States, Canada, and Mexico.
Players Nathan and Brandon told us their expectations for the season.
My name is Nathan Duva, and I play support and top. Practice has been fun. We've been just scrimming against other teams. Usually we just practice certain team comps with certain champions to find which one work best with each other.
Currently we're practicing and preparing for our first match, but for now we have two teams, Alma Blue and Alma Gold. Both teams will be competing in our high school league. Expectations for this year is that we'll make it deep into the playoffs, and hopefully we'll bring home a championship.
My expectations are that we go to finals and have some fun on the way because, my team is slept on.
Expectations are definitely to make it to playoffs and play some of the higher ranked teams. The biggest challenge that I think we'll be facing is just having the communication throughout the game. There's different lanes and different spots, and just having an overall understanding of each character I think is going to be kind of the hardest part.
Some challenges we're going to face is that we're all different ranks. Like, some of us are higher ranks than others, some of us know more than others, so communication is going to be key.
Hopefully that once we get it started, we can get a Twitch going and have the whole school and parents and other family members watch our students perform.
Now time for some Christian service announcements. Students going to adopt a grandparent this afternoon will meet in the Christian service office in the 600 wing to check in.
The 2020 Footprints Walk will take place at Kiefer Stadium on February 29th from 9 to noon. Please sign up online or on the sheets on the Christian service bulletin board.
Now let's take a look at what's going on in sports.
What's up, Lancers? We're back now. Let's take a look at this week in sports. Boys soccer beat Salesian 3-0 on Wednesday, and they have a game later today against LaSalle.
Girls soccer beat St. Joseph on Tuesday, and they had a game yesterday against St. Genevieve.
Girls basketball lost their game against Sarah on Tuesday, and they played against Kentwell last night.
Boys soccer beat LaSalle on Wednesday, and they play today against St. Genevieve in the Carroll Center. Make sure to come out and support our boys in blue. That's all for this week, Lancers. Make sure to keep up to date with everything Amat Sports by checking out thelance.org. And good luck to our Lancers competing today and this weekend.
See you all next week.
And now for some senior announcements. Seniors, your sweatshirts are in. Stop by the student store at lunch today to pick them up.
Attention all seniors planning to attend Mount SAC in the fall. A representative from Mount SAC will be on campus after school on Tuesday, February 18th to help you with the application process. Please see Mrs. George in the counseling department if you have any questions.
Seniors, please look at the email sent by Mr. Escobar last Friday regarding the senior collage. We'd like everyone to participate to send in pictures. If you have any questions, please ask Senior Joy Barrigan.
Okay, Jaden, say this is coming up. Do you have a date?
Nah, I don't.
Maybe next year. Tickets are available today at lunch in the student store for the Sadie Hawkins dance at Knott's Berry Farm. Online sales begin tomorrow. Join us for a very good time.
And now let's take a look at how the One Life Walk in LA turned out.
Give you all glory, all honor, and all praise. We love you, God.
Hello and welcome, and let's take a look at the One Life LA March. In this march, we all gathered to show our support for women going through crisis pregnancies and for the unborn who every day are denied the gift of life. The march started off as a long walk all the way to this nice park over here, the LA Historic Park. Here, people were able to picnic, eat at the vendors, and we even had a chance to check out a lot of tents of organizations who are giving to causes for every type of human life. Unborn, poor, homeless, sick, etc. Overall, this walk was a great experience, and in a community we gathered together to show our support for all human life and our love for God's creation. Thank you for watching and have a blessed day. Choose love.
Hi, my name is Madison Taran, and I am a Girl Scout working on my Gold Award here at Amat. The Gold Award is the most prestigious award that a Girl Scout can get, and only 5% of girls get it. So I'm going to be doing a segment on Lancers in the News for the month of February regarding other environmental issues. For the first video, it will be recycling. So, how to use the bins. So there are three compartments. There's paper, plastic, and cans. So the most important thing is no styrofoam in any of the bins. If there's styrofoam, we're going to have to toss out the entire bag. For plastics, you can keep the caps on if you want to. Cans are the most recyclable things. This includes sodas and all that. Paper, that can include napkins, homework. The most important thing is that whatever you put in recycling bins, they cannot have grease on them because if they are dirty, they can contaminate the entire batch. Thank you for helping me with my project.
Teresa Diaz, who graduated from AMAT 2014, is currently working at Mount SAC as a marine biological field researcher to spread awareness for environmental protection, specifically for our oceans. On Monday, February 10th in the library, Teresa will give a presentation about the earth, ocean pollution, and what we can do to protect nature's wonders.
Prayers are requested for one-time coach and longtime voice of the Lancers, Mr. Hayward.
That's all for this week, Lancers. Have a fascinating Friday.